Well, welcome back. It's time to bring in the branding and marketing guru. If you're Justin Trudeau, the Prime Minister is in trouble in the polls, way behind Conservative leader Pierre Poilievre in terms of preferred Prime Minister. This is from the folks at Nanos Research. And in fact, he's been there for months, accused by the opposition of being tired, elitist, out of ideas. So after 8 years in office, Team Trudeau looking for a way to turn things around. And today, confirmation that a marketing and branding specialist, Max Valiquette, his name, has been hired to oversee the communications and advertising teams of the Prime Minister's office. Let's bring back our front bench, Sabrina Grover, Larissa Waller, Gurraten Singh, and Rachel Aiello. And I'm going to start with you, Rachel. I like this one because, of course, optics, a big part of politics, whether we like it or not. Image is key. This guy, Max Valiquette, is a self-described expert in understanding millennials and Generation Z. Your read on what this means.
Yeah, I agree with you, Todd. I actually found this announcement today, this news first reported by the Hill Times, quite fascinating. It kind of brought me back to those days where you're looking at who's hiring who. But there are a couple points about his CV that I think are worth noting. He did work for Ben Simon Byrne. If you're a real political nerd, you'll recognize that name because that's the ad firm that did the Prime Minister's English language television ads in the 2015 campaign. You know, that escalator ad where he said Canadians just can't get ahead. And then when he was walking with Parliament Hill in the background acknowledging the Harper attack that he was just not ready. Award-winning campaign, I believe. So it's interesting to see that the Liberals are hearkening back to someone who worked for that firm to come into the fold now and essentially try to rebrand because, as we've covered, Todd, the Prime Minister is in a place right now, according to Nanos, where his party branding is worse or just as bad as it was when he took office, when he became leader, actually. So I think he is in need of a pivot. We'll see if this hire is enough to help that along, but certainly he's branding himself as a Gen Z kind of whisperer. So we'll see if that comes to fruition.
Yeah, Max Valiquette, by the way, 50 years old. I love this kind of stuff because I find it fascinating, the conversations that go on behind closed doors. To you, Gurraten, you know, his job likely revamp the impression the Canadians have of Justin Trudeau after 8 years.
I think the problem with this whole story for the Liberals is that the issue the Liberals are facing right now is less of a communications issue and far more, I think, of an actual policy and action issue. The reality is that 8 years after the Liberals have been in power, people are struggling. They're struggling with their cost of rent, the cost of housing, the cost of grocery bills. And bringing in someone to tell a better story of the Liberals' failure on that issue is not going to actually help the Liberals. And this is the real problem here. Aside from the NDPs, it's been able to push and pull the Liberals to make investments in dental care, and lay the foundation for pharma care and other steps that they brought in. The Liberals haven't done enough to help Canadians. And making this switch to a better storyteller won't help a bad story.
He's worked in the past, Larissa, for Nike, Budweiser, Coca-Cola. He's contributed to a lot of mainstream media. He once hosted his own show about youth issues on TV Ontario. And at one point, this guy was a comedian as well. The polls are awful. Can he turn things around? What do you make of this?
So I call my position in defense of communications professionals because I've worked in comms in politics for almost 20 years. I was in a meeting when I worked in one of my jobs. I won't say which one because I'll give it away. But we were getting roasted for a comms issue. And at some point, the policy guy who was sitting next to me leaned over and said, at some point, they're going to figure out it's not a comms problem. It's a policy problem. So, you know, in politics, the policy folks bake the cake. And then they hand the cake over to the comms folks and they say, okay, you ice the cake and you make it look pretty and you go sell the cake. But if the cake sucks, the cake sucks, right? If the cake doesn't taste good, there's nothing I can do on the outside to make the cake taste good. So to Gratton's point, it's a policy problem. And I'm sure this guy is the best there is. I read his CV as well. It's highly, highly impressive. But since Jerry Butts left, there feels like there's been a void in the Prime Minister's office. And I think they're trying to plug that hole with somebody serious, somebody who's highly accomplished. But at the end of the day, it's a policy problem. It's not a comms problem.
Sabrina, you're the Liberal here. How do you change the narrative after 8 years?
Well, can I just start by saying I think we could all use a Gen Z whisperer. I think, you know... I think that we've talked a lot, and you've heard over the last 6 months continuously on shows like this that the Liberals have a communications problem. A lot of that was solved, I think, this summer with a cabinet shift. You know, putting Sean Fraser into housing has rapidly turned housing around. We're hearing about housing every day. We know what's happening on that file. I think that was step one, and I think this is step two. And it is a good refresh to bring in some outside talent and some outside help. I think oftentimes we see staffers kind of hang around and move from office to office. And I think this was a really good move for the government to bring somebody from the outside who's, you know, been on the ground floor of communications with corporations, with business, with public sector. And to bring that kind of perspective in. I think there's absolutely an opportunity to turn things around. I would never say never on, you know, you could have a 14% lead today and that could be blown tomorrow. So I think that there's always an opportunity to turn things around. And I think the thing that Canadians want most is an ability to hear about stories about some of the things that have changed in their lives, right? I do think a bit of it is storytelling. Things like the childcare benefit, we talk about it really mechanically in terms of policy. I think what's better is for Canadians to hear the story about how childcare has revolutionized, you know, the lives of women and the lives of families in the economy. So I actually think this is a positive move for the Liberals, and I think we probably will see some really big changes.
Back to you, Rachel. Anyone watching the Liberals over the last 3 months, I know you have been doing that closely. You're seeing more and more vocal, open criticism by cabinet ministers about Pierre Poilievre. And, you know, perhaps part of the communication strategy here is, hey, you might not like our guy much anymore, but how about the other one? He's reckless, irresponsible, and he's certainly not ready for prime time. I wonder whether Max Valiquette will try to tap into that sentiment as well.
It's possible, Todd, but I really think the timing of this is also quite interesting just because of the week the Liberals just had. I think they were largely on the offensive and the Conservatives on their back heel. So bringing this person in short order and this news coming out today, I think is interesting. But to torture that cake metaphor a little bit more, you know, in this social media day and age, you can see a really pretty cake online and decide to buy it. And it's not until you take a big bite that you actually know what's on the inside. And that could be a fable for all parties right now in terms of making sure that their brand matches what they're actually offering Canadians. But I'm just really curious to see where this goes from here, if this is the start of a pivot where they try to turn things around for the Liberals, or if this was just kind of a blip one good week.
It's interesting, too, that his area of expertise, Garratton, is younger voters. And this is something that helped propel the prime minister to power 8 years ago. And now he's having a lot of issues with that demographic. A lot of them seem to be flirting with the Conservatives as well. So, you know, your read on what we might see in the months ahead. And I appreciate you're saying it's not just a communications issue, it's a policy issue. But if this guy is about branding and image and changing narratives, what do you think he's going to try to do?
Well, I'll say a point that I think needs to be understood by the Liberal Party and why they can't connect with Gen Z. Gen Z is the first generation in recent history that will have a lower quality of life than their parents. The reason why the Liberal Party is unable to connect with Gen Z is because they're not recognizing that the conditions of our current society are such that Gen Zers don't believe that they can own a home, or millennials don't believe they can own a home. They're struggling to get by with their bills. They're struggling to make ends meet. And to go back to the issue around this whole issue, policy versus communications, we'll see from the Liberals, or, you know, they'll probably try to, you know, shape or tell some sort of story about their policies. But until the conditions of Gen Zers and millennials are improved, until we see a reversal of the fact that they're the first generation to see a decrease in their quality of living, until we see meaningful action to housing and grocery prices, then no matter what story the Liberals tell, they will fail in telling it.
And part of that story, Larissa, might be that Pierre Poilievre is weak and not ready to become prime minister. And we're starting to already see that coming out of the Liberals in recent weeks, as I was saying.
Oh, I'm sure that's going to continue. Mm. I'm sure they're going to keep going after Pierre. And it's interesting that the other parties go after Pierre as well. You know, I think there's obviously the risk that Pierre is peaking too high too quickly, and that's going to be a challenge for the Conservatives to maintain that momentum for sure. But to Garratton's point, the Gen Zs today don't feel like they have a bright future. They are living in their parents' basement, and I'll say that Pierre's been talking about that for years. Pierre has been talking about the kids living in the basement who can't afford a house for years. And the other guys are just picking up on that now.
It's great to have all four of you with us. That's going to do it for the front bench. But appreciate you taking the time. Larissa, Sabrina, Garatin, and of course our very own Rachel Aiello. Have a great weekend ahead for all of you.
You too.